Avesta, Yashts and VENDIDAD of Zoroastrianism. By Alan Lewis Silva. Continues. Yashts. Footnote to Chapter 10. 30. Peshotanu, wretched sinner of deadly sins. End of footnote. 10. MITHRA. Continues. 73. We praise with harmony unto MITHRA, the Lord of wide pastures, sleepless, and ever awake. Who, with hands lifted up, rejoicing, cries out, speaking thus. 74. O Ahura Mazda, most beneficent spirit. Maker of the material world, thou Holy One. If men would worship me with a praise with harmony in which I were attuned by my own name, as they worship the other gods with praise with harmonies in which they are attuned by their own names, then I should come to the faithful at the appointed time, I should come in the appointed time of my beautiful, immortal life. 75. May we keep our field, may we never be exiles from our field, exiles from our house, exiles from our borough, exiles from our town, exiles from our country. 76. Thou dashest in pieces the malice of the malicious, the malice of the men of malice, dash thou in pieces the killers of faithful men. Thou hast good horses, thou hast a good chariot, thou art bringing help at every appeal, and art powerful. 77. I will pray unto thee for help, with many consecrations, with good consecrations of libations, with many offerings, with good offerings of libations, that we, abiding in thee, may long inhabit a good abode, full of all the riches that can be wished for. 78. Thou keepest those nations that tender a good worship to MITHRA, the Lord of wide pastures, thou dashest in pieces those that delight in havoc. Unto thee will I pray for help, may he come to us for help, the awful, most powerful MITHRA, the worshipful and praiseworthy, the glorious Lord of nations. For his brightness and glory, I will offer him a praise with harmony worth being heard. 79. We praise with harmony unto MITHRA, the Lord of wide pastures, sleepless, and ever awake. Who made a dwelling for Rashnu, and to whom Rashnu gave all his soul for long friendship. 80. Thou art a keeper and protector of the dwelling of those who lie not, thou art the maintainer of those who lie not. With thee hath Varetharakna, made by Ahura, contracted the best of all friendships, and thus it is how so many men who have lied unto MITHRA, even privily, lie smitten down on the ground. For his brightness and glory, I will offer him a praise with harmony worth being heard. 81. We praise with harmony unto MITHRA, the Lord of wide pastures, sleepless, and ever awake. Who made a dwelling for Rashnu, and to whom Rashnu gave all his soul for long friendship. 82. To whom Ahura Mazda gave 1,000 senses 93 and 10,000 eyes to see. With those eyes and those senses, he watches the man who injures MITHRA, the man who lies unto MITHRA. Through those eyes and those senses, he is undeceivable, he, of the 10,000 spies, the powerful, all-knowing, undeceivable God. For his brightness and glory, I will offer him a praise with harmony worth being heard. 83. We praise with harmony unto MITHRA, the Lord of wide pastures, sleepless, and ever awake. Whom the Lord of the country attunes for help, with hands uplifted. Whom the Lord of the town attunes for help, with hands uplifted. 84. Whom the Lord of the borough attunes for help, with hands uplifted. Whom the master of the house attunes for help, with hands uplifted. Whom the injured in danger of death attunes for help, with hands uplifted. Whom the poor man, who follows the good law, when wronged and deprived of his rights, attunes for help, with hands uplifted. 85. The voice of his wailing reaches up to the sky, it goes over the earth all around, it goes over the 7 Karshvayas, whether he utters his prayer in a low tone of voice or aloud. 86. The cow driven astray attunes him for help, longing for the stables. When will that bull, MITHRA, the Lord of wide pastures, bring us back, and make us reach the stables, when will he turn us back to the right way from the den of the Druge where we were driven? 87. And to him with whom Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, has been satisfied, he comes with help, and of him with whom Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, has been offended, he crushes down the house, the borough, the town, the province, the country. For his brightness and glory, I will offer him a praise with harmony worth being heard. 88. We praise with harmony unto Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, sleepless, and ever awake. To whom the enlivening, healing, fair, lordly, golden-eyed Hauma offered up a praise with harmony on the highest of the heights, on the Haridi Berza, he the undefiled to one undefiled, with undefiled Berzma, undefiled libations and undefiled words. 89. Whom the holy Ahura Mazda has established as a priest, quick in performing the praise with harmony and loud in song. He performed the praise with harmony with a loud voice, as a priest quick in praise with harmony and loud in song, a priest to Ahura Mazda, a priest to the Amisha Spenta. His voice reached up to the sky, went over the earth all around, went over the seven Keshwars. 90. Who first lifted up Haumas, in a mortar inlaid with stars and made of a heavenly substance. Ahura Mazda longed for him, the Amisha Spenta longed for him, for the well-slapen body of him whom the swift horse sun awakes for prayer from afar. 91. Hail to Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, who has 1,000 ears and 10,000 eyes. Thou art worthy of praise with harmony and prayer, mayest thou have praise with harmony and prayer in the houses of men. Hail to the man who shall offer thee a praise with harmony, with the holy wood in his hand, the berzma in his hand, the holy fruit in his hand, the holy mortar in his hand, with his hands well washed, with the mortar well washed, with the bundles of berzma tied up, the hauma uplifted, and the ahuna virya sung through. 92. The holy Ahura Mazda confessed that religion and so did Vohuman, so did Ashavahishta, so did Kshatharvarya, so did Spenta Armadi, so did Orvidat and Amarita, and all the Amisha Spenta longed for and confessed his religion. The kind Mazda conferred upon him the mastership of the world, and who saw thee amongst all creatures the right lord and master of the world, the best cleanser of these creatures. 93. So mayest thou in both worlds, mayest thou keep us in both worlds, O Mitra, Lord of wide pastures, both in this material world and in the world of the spirit, from the fiend of death, from the fiendishma, from the fiendish hordes, that lift up the spear of havoc, and from the onsets of Ishma, wherein the evil-doing Ishma rushes along with Vidotu, made by the Devas. 94. So mayest thou, O Mitra, Lord of wide pastures, give swiftness to our teams, strength to our own bodies, and that we may watch with full success those who hate us, smite down our foes, and destroy at one stroke our adversaries, our enemies, and those who hate us. For his brightness and glory, I will offer him a praise with harmony worth being heard. 95. We praise with harmony unto Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, sleepless, and ever awake. Who goes over the earth, all her breadth over, after the setting of the sun, touches both ends of this wide, round earth, whose ends lie afar, and surveys everything that is between the earth and the heavens. It should seem as if Mitra was supposed to retrace his steps during the night. The heathen supposed that the sun had a bright face and a dark one, and that during the night it returned from the west to the east with its dark face turned towards the earth. 96. Swinging in his hands a club with 100 knots, 100 edges, that rushes forwards and fells men down, a club cast out of red brass, of strong, golden brass, the strongest of all weapons, the most victorious of all weapons. 97. From whom Angramanyu, who is all death, flees away in fear, from whom Ishma, the evil-doing Peshhotanu, flees away in fear, from whom the long-handed Bushyasta flees away in fear, from whom all the Devas unseen and the Varenya fiends flee away in fear. 98. Oh, may we never fall across the rush of Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, when in anger. May Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, never smite us in his anger, he who stands up upon this earth as the strongest of all gods, the most valiant of all gods, the most energetic of all gods, the swiftest of all gods, the most fiend-smiting of all gods, he, Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures. For his brightness and glory, I will offer him a praise with harmony worth being heard. 99. We praise with harmony unto Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, sleepless, and ever awake. From whom all the devas unseen and the varenya fiends flee away in fear. The Lord of nations, Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, drives forward at the right-hand side of this wide, round earth, whose ends lie afar. 100. At his right hand drives the good, holy Sriasha, at his left hand drives the tall and strong Rashnu, on all sides around him drive the waters, the plants, and the Farvardhan of the faithful. 101. In his might, he ever brings to them falcon-feathered arrows, and, when diving, he himself comes there, where are nations, enemy to Mitra, he, first and foremost, strikes blows with his club on the horse and his rider, he throws fear and fright upon the horse and his rider. For his brightness and glory, I will offer him a praise with harmony worth being heard. 102. We praise with harmony unto Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, sleepless, and ever awake. The warrior of the white horse, of the sharp spear, the long spear, the quick arrows, foreseeing and clever. 103. Whom Ahura Mazda has established to maintain and look over all this moving world, and who maintains and looks over all this moving world, who, never sleeping, wakefully guards the creation of Mazda, who, never sleeping, wakefully maintains the creation of Mazda. For his brightness and glory, I will offer him a praise with harmony worth being heard. 104. We praise with harmony unto Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, sleepless, and ever awake. Whose long arms, strong with Mitra strength, encompass what he seizes in the easternmost river and what he beats with the westernmost river, what is by the Sanika of the Rangha and what is by the boundary of the earth. 105. And thou, O Mitra, encompassing all this around, do thou reach it, all over, with thy arms. The man without glory, led astray from the right way, grieves in his heart, the man without glory thinks thus in himself, that careless Mitra does not see all the evil that is done, nor all the lies that are told. 106. But I think thus in my heart. Should the evil thoughts of the earthly man be 100 times worse, they would not rise so high as the good thoughts of the heavenly Mitra. Should the evil words of the earthly man be 100 times worse, they would not rise so high as the good words of the heavenly Mitra. Should the evil deeds of the earthly man be 100 times worse, they would not rise so high as the good deeds of the heavenly Mitra. 107. Should the heavenly wisdom in the earthly man be 100 times greater, it would not rise so high as the heavenly wisdom in the heavenly Mitra. And thus, should the ears of the earthly man hear 100 times better, he would not hear so well as the heavenly Mitra, whose ear hears well who has 1,000 senses, and sees every man that tells a lie. Mitra stands up in his strength, he drives in the awfulness of royalty, and sends from his eyes beautiful looks that shine from afar. 108. Who will offer me a praise with harmony? Who will lie unto me? Who thinks me a god worthy of a good praise with harmony? Who thinks me worthy only of a bad praise with harmony? To whom shall I, in my might, impart brightness and glory? To whom bodily health? To whom shall I, in my might, impart riches and full will? Whom shall I bless by raising him a virtuous offspring? 109. To whom shall I give in return, without his thinking of it, the awful sovereignty, beautifully arrayed, with many armies, and most perfect, the sovereignty of an all-powerful tyrant, who fells down heads, valiant, smiting, and unsmitten, who orders chastisement to be done, and his order is done at once, which he has ordered in his anger. O Mitra, when thou art offended and not satisfied, he soothes thy mind, and makes Mitra satisfied. 110. To whom shall I, in my might, impart sickness and death? To whom shall I impart poverty and sterility? Of whom shall I at one stroke cut off the offspring? 111. From whom shall I take away, without his thinking of it, the awful sovereignty, beautifully arrayed, with many armies, and most perfect, the sovereignty of an all-powerful tyrant, who fells down heads, valiant, smiting, and unsmitten, who orders chastisement to be done and his order is done at once, which he has ordered in his anger. O Mitra, while thou art satisfied and not angry, he moves thy heart to anger, and makes Mitra unsatisfied. For his brightness and glory, I will offer him a praise with harmony worth being heard. 112. We praise with harmony unto Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, sleepless, and ever awake. A warrior with a silver helm, a golden cuirass, who kills with the poniard, strong, valiant, Lord of the burrow. Bright are the ways of Mitra, by which he goes towards the country, when, wishing well, he turns its plains and vales to pasture grounds. 113. And then cattle and males come to graze, as many as he wants. May Mitra and Ahura, the high gods, come to us for help, when the poniard lifts up its voice aloud, when the nostrils of the horses quiver, when the poniards lift up their voices aloud, when the strings of the bows whistle and shoot sharp arrows, then the brood of those whose libations are hated fall smitten to the ground with their hair scalped. 114. So mayest thou, O Mitra, Lord of wide pastures, give swiftness to our teams, strength to our own bodies, and that we may watch with full success those who hate us, smite down our foes, and destroy at one stroke our adversaries, our enemies, and those who hate us. For his brightness and glory, I will offer him a praise with harmony worth being heard. 115. We praise with harmony unto Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, sleepless, and ever awake. O Mitra, Lord of wide pastures, thou master of the house, of the burrow, of the town, of the country, thou Zarathustra Tema. 116. Mitra is 20-fold between two friends or two relations. Mitra is 30-fold between two men of the same group. Mitra is 40-fold between two partners. Mitra is 50-fold between wife and husband. Mitra is 60-fold between two disciples. Mitra is 70-fold between the disciple and his master. Mitra is 80-fold between the son-in-law and his father-in-law. Mitra is 90-fold between two brothers. 117. Mitra is 100-fold between the father and the son. Mitra is 1,000-fold between two nations. Mitra is 10,000-fold when connected with the law of Mazda, and then he will be every day of victorious strength. 118. May I come unto thee with a prayer that goes lowly or goes highly? As this sun rises up above the Hara Barazidi and then fulfills its career, so may I, O Spitama, with a prayer that goes lowly or goes highly, rise up above the will of the fiend Angramainyu. For his brightness and glory, I will offer him a praise with harmony worth being heard. 119. We praise with harmony unto Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, sleepless, and ever awake. Offer up a praise with harmony unto Mitra, O Spitama, and order thy disciples to do the same. Let the worshipper of Mazda praise with harmony unto thee with small cattle, with black cattle, with flying birds, gliding forward on wings. 120. To Mitra all the faithful worshippers of Mazda must give strength and energy with offered and proffered haumas, which the Zaotar proffers unto him and gives in praise with harmony. Let the faithful man drink of the libations cleanly prepared, which if he does, if he offers them unto Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, Mitra will be pleased with him and without anger. 121. Zarathustra asked him, O Ahura Mazda, how shall the faithful man drink the libations cleanly prepared, which if he does and he offers them unto Mithra, the Lord of wide pastures, Mithra will be pleased with him and without anger. 122. Ahura Mazda answered, Let them wash their bodies 3 days and 3 nights, let them undergo 30 strokes for the praise with harmony and prayer unto Mithra, the Lord of wide pastures. Let them wash their bodies 2 days and 2 nights, let them undergo 20 strokes for the praise with harmony and prayer unto Mithra, the Lord of wide pastures. Let no man drink of these libations who does not know the Stoda Yezna, Vice Bratavo. For his brightness and glory, I will offer him a sacrifice worth being heard. 123. We praise with harmony unto Mithra, the Lord of wide pastures, sleepless, and ever awake. To whom Ahura Mazda offered up a praise with harmony in the shining house of song. 124. With his arms lifted up towards immortality, Mithra, the Lord of wide pastures, drives forward from the shining house of song, in a beautiful chariot that drives on, ever swift, adorned with all sorts of ornaments, and made of gold. 125. 4 stallions draw that chariot, all of the same white color, living on heavenly food and undying. The hoofs of their 4 feet are shod with gold, the hoofs of their hind feet are shod with silver, all are yoked to the same pole, and wear the yoke and the crossbeams of the yoke, fastened with hooks of kshatravarya to a beautiful. 126. At his right hand drives Rashnurazishta, the most beneficent and most well-shapen. At his left hand drives the most upright Kista, the Holy One, bearing libations in her hands, clothed with white clothes, and white herself, and the cursing thought of the law of Mazda. 127. Close by him drives the strong cursing thought of the wise man, opposing foes in the shape of a boar, a sharp-toothed male boar, a sharp-jawed boar, that kills at one stroke, pursuing, wrathful, with a dripping face, strong and swift to run, and rushing all around. Behind him drives Adder, all in a blaze, and the awful kingly glory. 128. On a side of the chariot of Mithra, the Lord of wide pastures, stand 1,000 bows well made, with a string of cowgut, they go through the heavenly space, they fall through the heavenly space upon the skulls of the devas. 129. On a side of the chariot of Mithra, the Lord of wide pastures, stand 1,000 vulture-feathered arrows, with a golden mouth, with a horn shaft, with a brass tail, and well made. They go through the heavenly space, they fall through the heavenly space upon the skulls of the devas. 130. On a side of the chariot of Mithra, the Lord of wide pastures, stand 1,000 spears well made and sharp piercing. They go through the heavenly space, they fall through the heavenly space upon the skulls of the devas. On a side of the chariot of Mithra, the Lord of wide pastures, stand 1,000 steel hammers, two-edged, well made. They go through the heavenly space, they fall through the heavenly space upon the skulls of the devas. 131. On a side of the chariot of Mithra, the Lord of wide pastures, stand 1,000 swords, two-edged, and well made. They go through the heavenly space, they fall through the heavenly space upon the skulls of the devas. On a side of the chariot of Mithra, the Lord of wide pastures, stand 1,000 maces of iron, well made. They go through the heavenly space, they fall through the heavenly space upon the skulls of the devas. 132. On a side of the chariot of Mithra, the Lord of wide pastures, stands a beautiful well-falling club, with 100 knots, 100 edges, that rushes forward and fells men down, a club cast out of red brass, of strong, golden brass, the strongest of all weapons, the most victorious of all weapons. It goes through the heavenly space, it falls through the heavenly space upon the skulls of the devas. 133. After he has smitten the devas, after he has smitten down the men who lied unto Mithra, the Lord of wide pastures, drives forward through Arazat and Savay, through Fredad Hafshu and Vidad Hafshu, through Vaurabarshti and Vaurajarishti, through this Arkarshvar, the bright Vanarada. 134. Angramanyu, who is all death, flees away in fear, Ishma, the evil-doing Peshotanu, flees away in fear, the long-handed Bushyasta flees away in fear, all the Devas unseen and the Varenya fiends flee away in fear. 135. Oh, may we never fall across the rush of Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, when in anger. May Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, never smite us in his anger, he who stands up upon this earth as the strongest of all gods, the most valiant of all gods, the most energetic of all gods, the swiftest of all gods, the most fiend-smiting of all gods, he, Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures. For his brightness and glory, I will offer him a praise with harmony worth being heard. 136. We praise with harmony unto Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, sleepless, and ever awake. For whom white stallions, yoked to his chariot, draw it, on one golden wheel, with a full shining axle. 137. If Mitra takes his libations to his own dwelling, happy that man I think, said Ahura Mazda, O holy Zarathustra, for whom a holy priest, as pious as any in the world, who is the Word incarnate, offers up a praise with harmony unto Mitra with bundles of bearsma and with the words. Straight to that man I think will Mitra come, to visit his dwelling. 138. When Mitra's boons will come to him as he follows God's teaching and thinks according to God's teaching. Woe to that man I think, said Ahura Mazda, O holy Zarathustra, for whom an unholy priest, neither pious nor the Word incarnate, stands behind the bearsma, however full may be the bundles he ties of bearsma, however long he performs may be the praise with harmony. 139. He does not delight Ahura Mazda, nor the other Emishaspenta, nor Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, he who thus scorns Mazda, and the other Emishaspenta, and Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, and the Law and Rashnu and Arstad, who makes the world grow, who makes the world increase. For his brightness and glory, I will offer him a praise with harmony worth being heard. 140. We praise with harmony unto Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, sleepless, and ever awake. I will offer up a praise with harmony unto the good Mitra, O Spitama, unto the strong, heavenly God, who is foremost, highly merciful, and peerless, whose house is above, a stout and strong warrior. 141. Victorious and armed with a well-fashioned weapon, watchful in darkness and undeceivable. He is the stoutest of the stoutest, he is the strongest of the strongest, he is the most intelligent of the gods, he is victorious and endowed with glory, he, of the 10,000 eyes, of the 10,000 spies, the powerful, all-knowing, undeceivable God. For his brightness and glory, I will offer him a praise with harmony worth being heard. 142. We praise with harmony unto Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, sleepless, and ever awake. Who, with his manifold knowledge, powerfully increases the creation of Spenta Manu, and is a well-created and most great Yazida, self-shining like the moon, when he makes his own body shine. 143. Whose face is flashing with light like the face of the star Tistraya, whose chariot is embraced by that goddess who is foremost amongst those who have no deceit in them, O Spitama, who is fairer than any creature in the world, and full of light to shine. I will worship that chariot, wrought by the Maker, Ahura Mazda, inlaid with stars and made of a heavenly substance, of Mitra, who has 10,000 spies, the powerful, all-knowing, undeceivable God. For his brightness and glory, I will offer him a praise with harmony worth being heard. 144. We praise with harmony unto Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, who is truth-speaking, a chief in assemblies, with 1,000 ears, well-shapen, with 1,000 eyes, high, with full knowledge, strong, sleepless, and ever awake. We praise with harmony unto the Mitra around countries. We praise with harmony unto the Mitra within countries. We praise with harmony unto the Mitra in this country. We praise with harmony unto the Mitra above countries. We praise with harmony unto the Mitra under countries. We praise with harmony unto the Mitra before countries. We praise with harmony unto the Mitra behind countries. 145. We praise with harmony unto Mitra and Ahura, the two great, imperishable, holy gods, and unto the stars, and the moon, and the sun, with the trees that yield up bearsma. We praise with harmony unto Mitra, the Lord of all countries. For his brightness and glory, I will offer unto him a praise with harmony worth being heard, namely, unto Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures. Ahunavirya, the will of the Lord is the law of righteousness. The riches of the good mind reward all who minister in this world for wisdom, who work by God's purpose power to benefit the poor. I bless the praise with harmony and pure, and the strength and vigor of Mitra, the Lord of wide pastures, who has 1,000 ears, 10,000 eyes, a Yazida attuned by his own name, and that of Ramahvastra. Ashemvohu, righteousness is the most excellent good. It is also joy. Happy be the one freely choosing holiness. Unto that man brightness and glory. Give him the bright, all happy, blissful abode of the holy ones.